Hello everybody, I'd like to share with you something I discovered recently by accident. I got some Tig Welding electrodes for a project, and they're made from tungsten carbide. So out of curiosity, you can see on the pack there, the thickness is 1 mil. You can get these in 1.6 mil as well, and they come in all different varieties and mixtures. Some are zircon, I think, and for different welding different metals. And I think this is right for silver and gold. So they may be different hardnesses. Anyway, so as an experiment, I sharpened. Just cover it up for a minute so it don't distract you. I sharpened one of the electrodes. Incidentally, that's what they call red. They're red, so they come the different mixtures of tungsten carbide come in colours to separate the difference. And this is a red tip, anyway. So. Where's my thing? Right, so I sharpened it very similar to a, if I show you on a bigger graver, Steve Lindsay does a template, 70 degrees, I think they call it. It's a Carl Bliley deep line and banknote template, 70 degrees. So nowadays, because I'm kind of used to engraving, I sharpen by hand. So the way I sharpened this was, that's a cheap diamond stone for a handpiece. And just, I'll kind of demonstrate on this side, but this is the side I've done. Just kind of do it flat one side, the other side. You could kind of guess that. It's probably less than 70 degrees, maybe that's 80 or something. And then you rough it out with that, do a face angle. Again, nothing's really crucial. You can, after a while, you'll kind of get to know what works. So let's say that's about 45. You could go like more acute. So that was the first stage, using one of those. And then I used, these are zircon wheels. They will sharpen carbide. You can get wheels like this, diamond wheels. Otto Frill, I think that's how you pronounce it. They sell them. It's quite difficult to get this kind of stuff in the UK sometimes. But zircon, a lot cheaper. You have to be careful. I can imagine if I knock that, it would shatter, and then you've done your money. But they're about, say, $20, £20, I can't remember, but cheaper than the diamond wheels. And I've got a rough and a smooth, and I can get that to a mirror polish. And I don't know if it makes it, I mean, with this method, it's good to get it mirror sharp, because I don't use a, let me demonstrate again, I don't form a hill. So I go that side and that side and a face, you know, tidy up the face. So there's no hill. I think I kind of, so it's quite, what's that? That's about 6 inches long, it does say it on the box. It's the length for the electrode is 150 mil, and that's what creates the advantage for engraving with it, because I hold it like that, so I'm not kind of forcing the end. And when you I'll zoom in a little while. So 99% of the engraving I do is with an airgraver, and an airgraver is much easier to start engraving, because if you're at the wrong angle, the piston is still pushing it along. So whereas normally if you was trying to push engrave, you're digging deep and then you're trying to try and come out and then you're going to slip, or you're whoop and you're slipping. So that's why it's easier. It seems to me that you haven't got a heel, but that engraver, you're kind of pushing gently. Don't force it. Right, I'll engrave on this bit of aluminium now. Pushing gently. I probably will slip now that I'm on the camera, but right, so I'm pushing gently, and you can imagine that this is flexing and it's changing the angle constantly, so it kind of helps you out. And what I'll do, so you can see there, I've got some scroll work. Let's cover up so you don't get distracted. I've got some scroll work there and it requires shading, and I did all that scroll work with this Tig Welder electrode graver. So all that was shaded with this graver like I showed you. And that would be, if I was using a normal hand push engraver, I did slip a couple of times. Obviously, even with an airgraver you slip now and again, but let me show you. I think because you're holding it from the side, you haven't got a handle, you can't over push it. And like I said, the flexibility is making minute changes. I think if you're learning to hand engrave, they're not that expensive as well. You get 10 in a pack, so you can make a few gravers. Carbide gravers are quite expensive, carbide blanks are quite expensive, and you don't need a massive blank. I did try it on steel, obviously didn't go very deep. You're not really forcing, because it's sharp, you're not really forcing it. I think there's a subtle thing where I'm kind of pressing down with my index finger as well. Yeah, I did slip there. Alright. Not too bad though. Like the times when I've tried to push engrave, when you slip, you make a right old mess. Like, you can repair it, but so I never bothered. But this, so and like I said, the only practice I've done with this is probably for an hour. So if you was learning to hand engrave and you could do that within an hour, I think that's quite good. So imagine you spend a couple of months. I think it's the combination of nice sharp graver so it doesn't require, if you're not pushing very hard, then even if you do slip, you're not going to make too much of a mess. And look, you can do a really, look, see, I'm still experimenting. That's a beautiful fine line. So if you want to do some bolino, you could do nice, show you there, you could do nice. So I'll do it as light as I can. You can do some nice cross hatching, and bolino is also that. I'm just going to do this one more leaf. So you might have some TIG welder electrodes lying around, give it a go. I won't do it now. I'll probably make a video on its own of sharpening it, just so you've got an idea. And I mean, you can see it there shiny. Let me Well, I'll zoom out, you can see the whole thing. Thanks, cheers, bye bye.